Hello there, y'all. This is Lightning Bolt Forever, back with more Star Wars Dark Forces. Last time, we planted a tracking device on the Empire smuggler ship, and now we have tracked it to the robotics construction facility on Antivy in Mission 8, Ice Station Beta. So, this ship is hauling parts to build Dark Troopers, and so what we have to do on the cold, frigid, icy, lifeless planet of Antivy here is we have to do pretty much what we did back on Gromos. We have to infiltrate the facility, set sequencer charges 1, 2, and 3 to blow the place up, and get back to the landing area with Jan and the Crow. So let's go on in. All right. And we are officially halfway done with our adventure here, which is kind of weird to say, but yeah, here we are. So this level straight away has our first secret right in here. And if we go on in here, there's nothing in here but an extra life and a pretty cool Easter egg. If we pull up the overlay map by hitting the tab key, look at the shape that's being drawn out here. Now this room is not shaped like what it looks like on the map, but take a look at this. That design might look a little familiar, and if we type in a code to fill in the map, hey, check it out, it's Max from the Sam and Max Adventure games. Yep, this is not the, Dark Forces 2 is not the only time that Max made an appearance in the Jedi Knight series. His face can be seen right here on the overlay map, which is pretty neat. And, yeah, it's kind of random that his face is just kind of here, but anyhow, let's go ahead and continue on with our little adventure here. So this level introduces ice physics. Now, you can see a difference in the two textures right here. I guess slippery looking is really the best way I can describe it. You walk on here, and I'm not moving. Kyle's just slipping and sliding right around on the ice here. And that can make him a little difficult to control, and we've got some frigid, icy water here. Doesn't really do anything to you, but you do move slower in it. And now that we're here, here is the facility. And if we just kind of sneak in here, where did that come from? Oh! We've got a couple of guys up there that I want to take out now. Did I get them all? I guess I did. There he is. Yep, there's a turret up there. We can go ahead and get rid of it. Yeah, I guess that was all the troopers. Anyhow, there's nothing else really in this area except from an icy waterfall here. It somehow is not frozen over. But let's go ahead and head back to where we were back at the start here. And what we're going to do, we can go either to the left or to the right. I'm going to go to the right because we'll eventually be working our way all the way around the base here. So let's just take out some troopers here. There's nothing in this part here except a frozen little lake there. And we can go on up the stairs. This way is just a dead end down here. We can go around this way, all the way around. And we have a trooper out there. I'd like to get down like that. And right here we got some slippery ice. Now if we fall right here, we just picked up a new item, the ice cleats. And the ice cleats will automatically work as soon as you collect them. Kyle will automatically put them on. And we can now freely walk and run on the ice without slipping and potentially falling off of cliffs. Which is very handy in this level, but I think this is really the only level you need the ice cleats for. I guess Kyle just wears them throughout the rest of the game. That'd be kind of funny if he did. But anyhow, let's work our way around here. Get those guys. And him and that guy, alright. And there's a couple of guys up there. Nice, alright, got them all. However many were up there, I don't know. Anyway, next secret number 2, is down in here. Shields and power cells. Alright. And it's after you clear out this little gang of stormtroopers here. There's nothing down here. But we can sort of sneak in this way, like this. This is on the way to secrets 3 and 4, which are in the same place. If we run all the way down to the end of this little path here, we'll find this secret here with some items, and we can continue all the way down, get some power cells here. There are turrets up above, but It's really best if you just ignore them and not and just save your ammo and not try to bother with them too much. Let's go ahead and grab those shields. Anyway, our next secret number 4, is actually right through here. Yep, so it's all there. Yeah, secrets 3 and 4 are in the same place. So we'll just go ahead and leave there. Hop back out like so. Yeah, this place can be a little... Oh, really? Just gonna take pot shots at me from up above. You will be destroyed like so. All right. We can hop behind this icy waterfall here. So, yeah, and this is not a secret. You actually have to go up this way to get the blue key. But this level, it can be a little confusing. Just because everything kind of looks the same in the beginning. It's sort of like a couple levels ago back in level 4. But once you figure your way around here, it's really not that bad. We're basically taking one huge lap around the perimeter of the base here. And most of these little side areas here are dead ends anyway. But anyhow, we got the blue key. And now we'll get to taking out some baddies here. Like so. Yeah. All right. That's them. Get him down. And ooh, there's a lot of them. Blow them up. Sweet. We'll collect their guns. All right, so we will go up those stairs in a second. Let's jump back over here. And this is going to take us out back to the beginning. See, this is where we were before. So, well, obviously. Nice. Nice insight there. Anyhow, let's get into the base. So let's go up the stairs here. Open up the door, and we are taken onto the conveyor belt. So we'll just ride it as much as... Well, yeah, we'll ride it to the end here. And we took out the turrets already, thankfully. And this is all... Yeah, we've seen... This is everything we're passing by is stuff we've already seen, so... Again, looks confusing at first, really not that bad in the end. Let's blow that up, and let's get the mortar launcher out, aka the toaster, as you guys so affectionately referred to it as. And we will hop in here for a secret. Yeah, somehow Kyle can actually fit through these windows. He's a very agile spaceman. Anyhow, continuing along. Go down this way, and we got... Nope, that's not... There we go. That's what I wanted. Not want those daggone landmines. Anyway, we're above the area where we got secrets 3 and 4. Now, as you can see, in that room, there are a bunch of items. Now, I believe you can get into that room. It is possible, but you have to be really good at timing your jumps with, like, crouching and all that stuff, and I am really not... It's a tricky thing to do. I'm really not that skilled in terms of, like, you know... badassery speedrunning controls and all that stuff. So what we're going to do is shoot the target, run past the turrets, just ignore them, and get in here. So now we've made it inside the base, and believe it or not, coming into the base actually counts as a secret for some reason. Anyhow, this door does not open, so we'll just make our way on down. Get rid of those two guys. Now, watch this here. See that up there? The difference in the ceiling patterns? That's a crusher right there. What you want to do is quickly get through before you get crushed. And now here, we got some toxic sludge, which will do damage to us. So let's scale the wall here carefully and leap across. Make all these daring platformer moves here, and we'll jump up here and, yeah, make it inside. Now right here, we'll just sneak under the crusher. Let's go ahead and get the bread launcher out again. oh, no, wait, not yet. We want to take out that turret first. And then I think we'll take out the mortar gun here. Yep, because I wanted to use it on those guys there. And then on... Whoops. Yeah, I was going to use an explosive weapon, but those guys are too close. Anyhow, what we need to do is hop over to here. And we just picked up a shield supercharge, which doesn't make our health... Well, basically, it's like sort of temporary half-invincibility. Because what it does is... Our shields are now impervious to damage, but our health itself is not. If we you know, get hit by any melee attacks, we will take damage there, but not shields. And here's a pretty cool hologram. I'm not sure who this is of, but maybe... Shoot, it could be Kyle for all we know. Anyhow, let's go this way. Get rid of all those guys in there. All right. And now what we'll do is hop across... Get rid of these guys before we lose our shield supercharge. All right, so they're taken care of. We'll be back in this area. We'll actually be coming through that door in just a hot second here. And the way we do that is run in here. You don't even have to jump. Just run straight in. Pick up the red key off the officer. Hit this switch, and then you can get into here. And then we can open up these doors... Get rid of that guy. Collect whatever we need. We have another gas mask, and then what we can do is hit this switch, and the wall opens up. So we'll jump inside, and we will follow the path, and hit this switch here, which opens up these two areas here, and then hit this switch, which stops the turbine, and check it out. You might think this is a bit of a Duke Nukem 3D Episode 2 Level 9-esque type of area here, but this game was released 2 years before Duke 3D, so technically Duke kind of borrowed some ideas from this game. Anyway, what we need to do is drop down, and we take a massive amount of damage, which is okay, because we do get a revive. Now, as you can see in this area, this sign is warning us that there is toxic gas in the place. Well, I'm not sure if I'm just getting, like, some sort of glitch, or if I'm just getting lucky here, but I've never had to use the gas mask in this area. I think what's supposed to happen is you drop down in here and you have to throw on the gas mask, but, yeah, I don't really, you know, you don't really need to, because, well, at least I don't, because I'm not taking any damage here. Anyhow, let's go ahead and place the sequencer charges.
Charge one set.
Charge one. Yeah, there are three little corners, quote-unquote, here, so let's jump into here.
Charge two set.
Charge two. And if we go around this way... Charge three.
All charges set.
Good job. Let's blow this ice cube.
Woman after my own heart.
Oh boy, what is that thing? Uh-oh. Whatever it is, it's firing rockets at us and... Wait a second, it looks... Doesn't look human. Aha, this is a Phase 2. Whoa, this is a Phase 2 Dark Trooper. Now these guys are a lot tougher than the Phase 1s, of course. Yeah, the one we fought on Gromos on the Blood Moon, that was just a Phase 1. This guy has long-range attacks. He has a plasma cannon he's firing at us, and rockets, and he can fly. So we'll just use the mortar launcher on him here, and he should... Yeah, he is fast, but he doesn't take that many hits. And you can grab some missiles off of him, but yeah, here he is. Yeah, this guy definitely looks more like the ones in The Mandalorian there. But anyhow, a door has now opened up now that we've defeated him. Here we go. Right in here, we have a bag of mines. We can open this up, and what we're going to find here... Let's keep that open. Because this opens up, and we have a Phase 1... Whoa, we have a Phase 1 trooper again. So if we crouch, there we go. Yeah, if you crouch and fire at him, his shots won't ricochet back at you. But we can go in to his little quarters there, grab a weapon supercharge, and this area here is kind of maze-like, but it's not very big, so it's easy to find your way around here. Where did he go? Whoa! Come on, go down now. Damn, he's good at blocking there. Well, yeah, we'll toss a bomb at him. Get rid of him that way. get some more mines. I think we should have one more that we have to deal with here in this... Looks like we're in like a giant computer or something. It's pretty neat. Let's get this out. Whoa! Did a little more damage to myself than I would have hoped! Oh, jeez. Oh, no, okay. Okay, that was a little scary. But I think that is the last of them. So, I have no armor, man. Not the most ideal shape to be in right now. Anyhow, let's turn that off. Ah, here we go. Let's leap across, not fall into the pit there. And we're actually getting back to the area where we picked up the ice cleats. We picked them up right here. And now all that we have to do is just make it back to the landing area where Jan is. Because we planted the charges. And it's time to get the heck out of Dodge here. Alright, and we'll go hopping on back. And there she is. Alrighty. The crow has landed. So let's check and see how we did. Alright, we did all of our objectives and we found all the secrets. So with that, next time, I will see you in a familiar place. I will see you in the Vertical City on none other than Nar Shaddaa, where we began our Dark Forces 2 adventure. So until then, this is Lightning Bolt Forever, and I'll catch you later.
We'll be right back.